How long will it take us to reach Proxima Centauri? If we were to go by an F1 car, it would take us approximately 25,600,000 years, stops included.
If we manage to leave on a rocket at the constant speed of 25,000 miles per hour,
or 11.2 kilometers per second, the speed needed to escape the Earth's gravity, we would be there in something like 113,730 years. Even with the fastest speed ever reached by a human-made spacecraft, 364,620 miles per hour, 163 kilometers per second, achieved by the Solar Parker probe at perihelion, our trip will take a really long time, about 7,815 years. These are all gross approximations, but reaching Proxima Centauri would not only be a matter of time. Even if you are in space and there's so much out there to be seen, boredom would probably kick in sooner than you expected, and you'll find yourself in a metal cabin with always the same people, always the same faces. It would be really hard to reach Proxima Centauri from a mental, logistic, and physical point of view. Come join us and watch this amazing video to learn how long it would take us and what's the best way to reach Proxima Centauri. You'll also find out what we could find once we get there. Proxima Centauri is the closest star to Earth, and it was discovered in 1915, almost 108 years ago. It's actually one of three known stars in the Alpha Centauri system, with the other two stars being Alpha Centauri A and B. Formerly, before this announcement, astronomers believed that Alpha Centauri was the closest star to our solar system. This is a red dwarf, probably the most common stellar type in the Milky Way, dim and relatively cold. It has a little more than the age of the Sun, about 4.8 billion years, but a diameter that is only 15% of that of the Sun and a surface temperature of only about 2,725 degrees Celsius, against the 5,725 degrees Celsius of our star. The star lies about 25.6 trillion miles away. This means that it would take an immense amount of time to reach it. Even if traveling at the speed of light, it will take us a long time to go there, 4,244 years to reach. In reality, traveling at the speed of light is impossible, as the speed of light is something that we can only approach, not become. And it would require immense amounts of fuel and energy, something that is not feasible at this current time. Anyway, now try to follow me with this. We know that Proxima Centauri's position in the universe changes with time, just like the Sun moves along with other stars around the center of our galaxy. How do we know how much the position of a star is changing? The answer is proper motion. Proper motion is the motion of stars relative to the observer on Earth. It can be visualized as the movement of a star across the night sky. For example, Proxima Centauri is moving at an estimated 3.8 arc seconds per year. This means that if you look at Proxima Centauri through a telescope, it will appear to move every year as seen from Earth. Another example would be Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky. It is moving at a rate of 2.17 arc seconds per year. So the stars in our galaxy are constantly moving, and Proxima Centauri is no exception. This means that by the time we reach it, the position would have changed, also changing the required time to reach it with our fastest spacecraft. By the way, here's an interesting thing linked to the proper motion of Proxima Centauri. Because it is the closest star to our Sun, its angular motion across the sky is relatively fast compared to far more distant background stars. In 2014 and 2016, Proxima Centauri passed in front of two background stars that are along its path. This afforded astronomers a rare opportunity to study the warping of space by Proxima's gravity. This effect is called gravitational lensing. The amount of warping could be used to calculate a precise mass for Proxima Centauri and look for the gravitational footprint and any exoplanets orbiting the star. Unluckily for scientists, they didn't have the chance to observe any exoplanets because the odds of it happening were really small. But in 2016, the discovery of Proxima B planet was announced by the radial velocity method. It is probably a rocky planet whose recently reassessed minimum mass may be as little as 1.17 Earth masses. Although Proxima B is about 20 times closer to its star than Earth is to the Sun, it receives comparable energy. This means that the surface temperature could favor the presence of liquid water, if there is any, and support the development of life. At the moment, three planets are known to orbit around Proxima Centauri. This is really important for us because any conceived mission to reach the star would also likely imply the first close study of an exoplanet. Isn't it amazing? Anyway, we understand that it's impossible for one single person to leave the Earth and reach this star in the arc of a lifetime. Some crazy students try to find out what's the smallest crew that could maintain a genetically healthy population over such time frames. To reach and potentially settle the star, a crew of humans would need to complete a 6,300-year journey. This is the estimated amount of time needed to reach the star with our current technology. Researchers Frederic Marais and Camille Beloufi determined that at least 98 settlers, or 49 breeding pairs, is necessary to maintain a genetically healthy population over this lengthy journey. The minimum crew size might change depending on fertility rates in deep space, potential mutational effects from radiation, and other social factors. Such a mission would be a daunting challenge, but has the potential to unlock humanity's ability to explore and colonize the rest of the universe. So the question is, are we able to conceive and build a spacecraft capable of hosting generations of humans? Some proponents of interstellar travel recommend sending spacecraft that are essentially miniaturized worlds that can accommodate travelers for centuries or longer. These are called generation spaceships. The logic behind a generation ship is simple. If you can travel fast enough to get to another star system within a single lifetime, build a vessel large enough to carry everything you would possibly need for a long voyage. This would entail making sure that a ship has a reliable propulsion system that can provide steady thrust during acceleration and deceleration, and the necessary amenities to provide for several generations of humans. As we are far from building a successful generation spaceship, unmanned interstellar travel could become a reality in our lifetime. A team of scientists from the Australian National University, ANU, has designed an array of lasers that will help propel a fleet of tiny spacecraft known as nanoprobes to the distant star system Alpha Centauri, where Proxima Centauri is also located. This kind of spacecraft makes use of the famous solar sail propulsion system. The laser array will be made up of millions of lasers positioned on Earth's surface and generate 100 gigawatts of power. Using photon propulsion, a journey to Alpha Centauri would take between 20 to 30 years, compared to 100 generations if we were to use a traditional propulsion system. ANU is already working on building the basic building blocks in a laboratory environment, and the journey could be ready by 2036, with Alpha Centauri in our sights by 2060. This is part of the so-called Breakthrough Starshot project. It is an ambitious mission that could bring us closer to unlocking the mysteries of our universe. Who knows? We might even get a glimpse of the potentially habitable planet Proxima B. So here's to hoping that the ANU team can make interstellar travel a reality. If you want, you can find more information about solar sail at the link below. And while you're still there, it means you're really enjoying this video. Why don't you take a moment and subscribe to the channel? But what if we discovered a way to travel at the speed of light? Enter the Alcubierre warp drive. The Alcubierre warp drive is a hypothetical tool that has been theorized in the science of theoretical physics. It would be capable of propelling us to the stars in a matter of days and could make interstellar travel a reality. Based on the concept of a warp field, the Alcubierre warp drive works by distorting the fabric of space-time using a propulsion system that would be able to travel faster than the speed of light. When activated, an Alcubierre warp drive would create a bolt of energy that encircles the spacecraft. This bolt would cause space-time to expand in the front of the ship while contracting in the rear, creating a bow wave. This would serve as a cushion, effectively allowing the ship to move faster than the speed of light without breaking any physical laws. Theoretically, an Alcubierre warp drive would be able to travel to Proxima Centauri in a matter of days, but in reality, this technology is still in its infancy. Scientists still have to figure out how to generate enough energy to be able to create and sustain a warp field. Despite this, the idea of an Alcubierre warp drive has gained traction in recent years, with scientists around the world attempting to figure out a way to make this technology a reality. If scientists ever managed to unlock the secrets of Alcubierre warp drive, it would revolutionize the way we travel and explore the universe, and would bring us a step closer to our dream of reaching the stars. So to recap, given our current technology, it would be impossible for us to travel to Proxima Centauri. To make this journey possible, scientists would need to find a way to move almost at the speed of light and develop a technology to combat the effects of interstellar travel. Until this happens, it could take us hundreds of thousands of years to reach the closest star. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you think we'll ever reach Proxima Centauri or not? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.